Hi dear students, today we'll read poem I Dream a World, written by Langston Hughes. This beautiful poem presents before us the dream vision of an ideal world where everywhere there is freedom. This poem is all about hope for equality and end of discrimination, end of all the differences, especially differences between black and white people. Here, through this poem, the poet dreams of a world where there is no racial boundary, no differences between the people. All people live in harmony and freedom. This is a little idea about the poem. Now, I'll tell you the meaning of every stanza with its explanation. First stanza is, I dream a world where man no other will scorn, where love will bless the earth and peace its path adorn. First meaning is scorn. Meaning of scorn is, you see, S-C-O-R-N, it's hates. Then next is adorn. Adorn means decorated. Alright. And the meaning of this stanza, not explanation, first meaning of the lines written here. I dream a world where all men love each other and no one hates the other. Where there is love all around and the earth is blessed with loving feelings for humanity. Last line, and peace its path adorn. Every path of poet's dream is decorated with peace only. Peace its path adorn means all the paths are decorated with peace. Now explanation of this stanza. In this stanza, the poet has presented a vision of an ideal world where human life is blessed with love. He means to say that man is born in this world to love his fellow beings. There is a rule of love in his dream world. There are no negative feelings like hatred, and people do not have ill feelings for each other. Where there is love, there is peace. He wishes to see every path of his dream world decorated with peace. And there are no riots. Riots means no fights and killings on the basis of color and race. In short, he presents a dream vision of an ideal world where people enjoy love and peace all around. In the next stanza, I dream a world where all will know sweet freedom's way, where greed no longer saps the soul, nor avarice blights our day. Here, first of all, the meaning of the words. Is saps. Saps means weaken or destroy. Saps the soul. A thing which destroys the soul or weakens the soul. Avarice means greed or lust for money and wealth. Then blights something, a state of physical or mental suffering which destroys somebody's. It's a kind of pain. Meaning of these lines. I dream a world where all men are free and enjoy freedom equally. They know the real taste of freedom. In my dream world, greed does not destroy the soul of man. Their extreme lust for riches and wealth does not spoil the nature of man, especially when he is on the top of social position. Now, what does the poet wants to say by these lines? In the second stanza, what does the poet means to say? In this stanza, the poet wants to impress upon the readers that freedom is the right of every man living on the face of this earth. He dreams such a world where everyone enjoys freedom, irrespective of caste, color and creed. No social evils like greed and lust exist among the people. And in this dream world, every man has a strong moral character and greed can never destroy his noble soul. They are so morally strong that even if they are on the top social position, they remain humble and never rob others of whatever belongs to them. Therefore, the poet dreams of complete freedom and strong moral character of the people in this stanza in his dream world. Now, third stanza, a world I dream where black or white, whatever race you be, will share the bounties of the earth and every man is free. Here bounties means gift of nature in abundance. Means everybody should share these all bounties equally. Here, the meaning of the lines first in the words of the poet. A world that I dream about is free from all kinds of discrimination. There is no difference between black and white. All men are equal, no matter which race they belong to. All people in my dream world enjoy the resources of the earth equally. They have riches of the world without any racial differences. In my dream, here I am telling you the in the words of poet only, in my dream world, people are completely free to think and to act. Now, explanation of this whole stanza. What does the poet means to convey here, means to say? In this stanza, the poet wishes to live in the world where all men are considered equal. He means to convey a message to the white race that all men are created by Almighty, by God, and they are equal in the eyes of God. In his dream world, there is no difference between black and white people. His dream world is free from discrimination, free from differences on the basis of caste, color and creed. He visualizes a world where resources of the earth are not enjoyed by a particular group of people and nations, but it's enjoyed by all the people equally. They enjoy the riches, all the riches, all the facilities equally while living in their beloved land. Everyone enjoys complete freedom and they have freedom of thought and action. In the next stanza, where richness will hang its head and joy like a pearl attends the needs of all mankind, of such I dream our world. Richness means pain, a state of physical or mental suffering, a state of physical pain or mental pain. The meaning of these lines: I dream a world where there is no poverty and misery. People enjoy their bread and butter and never face any shortage of basic necessities of life. In his dream world, happiness is the right of all. Here joy is like a pearl which serves the people equally and fulfill their needs. I dream a world, such an ideal world to call our own. These are the meaning, only the meaning of the lines given. But now explanation of this whole stanza is, the poet here wants to say that he dreams of a world where poverty and misery do not exist to people who are in trouble. His dream world is prosperous and the needs of people are easily fulfilled. People enjoy all the resources of the earth equally. And money is not hoarded in few hands, but is equally distributed among all the people of the society, no matter what is their caste, color or creed. In his ideal world, joy is like a pearl, which is in the possession of every man serving his needs. Therefore, all people are prosperous and living a peaceful life. So students, this is all about the summary of poem I Dream a World. I hope you have understood the meaning of each and every stanza. Thank you, students.